0.5 with the values lambda 0.1 and the 0.4, we have the expression of lambda. We have the expression of L is going to be like this one. It is a small difference with the simple logistic distribution. But we will see that if we use the, we will see in the chart, if we use the not the correct RL, not the correct L for the mixer model, we will see there is some error on this part. This is the RL of the ML5, where RL not is with this value of L is around the 370. It seems in the lambda equals to 0.3 and lambda equals to 0.4. This is when we plot the mixture data, which is the Wind Chicago and Wind Florida, we use the same value of L, which is the value of the simple logistic distribution. With p equals to 0.1 until p equals to 4, and the control, the out of control is to be 12, 8, 7, and 8 respectively. There is some difference with this if you plot the mixture distribution with the exact L value with the mixture model, and then this is the chart for the exact value of the exact value of L with respectively value of P. We have the out of control is 12, 8, 6, 7, and 7 respectively. In this part, the difference is in the p equals to 4. The higher value of p, it will have the more difference in the comparison of the in the chart of a mixer logistic UMA. Then the conclusion, the summary of conclusion of the thesis is we had the flawed the twisted mixture distribution and derived some important properties of the distribution, includes the MGF, characteristic function, moment, survival, and hazard function of the distribution. We also had the flawed the parameter estimation of the twisted mixture distribution, such as method of moment estimation and maximum likelihood estimation. Then we had discussed the replication of the two-stage mixture logistic distribution in human population growth, item response theory, and statistical process control. And possible future work of this thesis is we have also logistic distribution may also be mixed with the other types of distribution where we could derive the properties as well as the parameter estimation. We may also can develop other parameter estimation, such as Bayesian estimation of the distribution, which has not yet been studied in this thesis. We must also discuss the other application of the logistic distribution, such as in survival analysis and many other things. And then the last is the expected ISI publication of the coming from this thesis is about the estimation of the mean of the mixture distribution and its possible application. It will possible also to have other application, but this is the first publication that we expect to be published in the ISI publication. Acknowledgement. Thank you to Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, Dean of Ahad University, Dean of Graduate Studies, to give me opportunity to study in the Applied Statistics, and then Department of Mathematics Statistics, Chairman, Faculty and Staff, and also my advisor, Dr. Omar, my committee member, Dr. Muhammad Riaz, Dr. Munjid, also my family, parents, wife, son, daughter, and sister, to give me chance to study here, and then also Indonesian community and KUKM and Wina Howard. Thank you.
But you need to pace yourself so that you talk around 40 minutes is okay, 40, 42, 45 to 45. Then that will give about 10 minutes for questions. So then there's I think your pronunciation, because you talk too fast, you talk like Indonesian. So then, for example, you say develop, you say develop. And so on, so you should say develop, right? Develop. So something like this. So also some other places where you have develop, I think it's no problem. But when you go to the pronunciation for certain things, like for example, arbitrary point, you need to say arbitrary point so that people understand what you're talking about. So you have extra. This is an arbitrary point. Also degenerate distribution. I think things that are statistical to your thesis and your presentation, you need to make it clear. So don't be rushing in terms of pronouncing those words. Yuma is fine. Even if you go fast, we understand because the people always talk about Yuma. Arbitrary point, degenerate distribution, all these people probably are not too familiar with. Mixture distribution, fine, because you always talk to me, then this is fine. But I think arbitrary point, because you usually don't talk too much about. And then also, none of your slides are animated.
Yes.
I think you should animate, because then, while animating, then you can talk. So then it becomes easier for you, especially the important slides. If you go back to some of your slides, especially, let's go look at starting on slide number 5.
Slide 5?
Yeah. See, this one is a very important slide, right? So you might want to animate this. You might want to show the what is the 1PL. Is there a way you can animate this graph?
Into graph? That takes a...
No. But if you can, that's fine. But at least here, you may want to say the color of 1PL is should be made the same as the graph.
This is all 2PL, this one.
This is all 2PL, okay.
It's with different value of parameter.
Okay. So, and also those numbers, that's too small.
Yeah.
They're from the back, nobody can see it. So is there a way you can make those bigger? Or maybe just put down there somewhere at the bottom here the legend. Make
okay.
a bigger extra.
So the legend will be outside.
Yeah, yeah. You have those legends, it's fine. But then you make an extra legend down here.
Okay.
Extra legend down here to show, you see. So you can make an extra legend down here for the different graph
okay.
values and so on and so forth. So then they can see what is going on.
Okay.
So that.
Okay. Right now,
Yeah, I have it here.
Okay.
So I will see.
You will send this in email?
Yeah, so I'm not sure how to make this into email.
Just copy it.
Copy? And then
okay.
Yeah, so then copy and paste it. So that is one. Okay, so if you go to the other slide where you have mixture. This one is the most important. No, so this after this, yeah, this one. This definitely must be animated. See, because why? Then you can show where the inflection points are. And here, this graph, you can see, so look at this, this should be the animation inflection point, okay? And then it should be another inflection point here.
Yes.
Here. So this is what is, so this is why it goes like this, and it goes down, and then inflect again, so there's two inflection points, one inflection point here, and there's another inflection point here. And that's usually typical of having subpopulations that are different from each other. If the subpopulations are very close to each other, you don't see this much of this two inflection points. The others, like for example this one here, this looks still like the S-curve, right? Because the difference between this and this are not too far away. So the others are but is the model is general enough because it can also capture the other kinds of distributions. But they are basically the same, so you have only one subpopulation only. It's only one population. So this is two subpopulations, one subpopulation here, one subpopulation here, right? politically. So this is why you see this is an inflection point here, this is another inflection point. So I think when you see inflection point, also you don't explain a little bit what is inflection point, right?
Yeah.
So you should take the time, because this the when you see the mixture distribution, inflection point is the something that actually, if you just look at the raw data, and you just do the CDF, then you see two inflection points that may tell you that you need a mixture distribution. Right? This is like the population for the Australia.
Yeah.
So you see that there is an inflection point here. Oh, there is another inflection point there. I don't think I can fit with one distribution. So in this case, then the 1PL, the 2PL, the 3PL may not work, but you may need the mixture distribution. So this is what sells the mixture distribution for you.
Mm.
Yeah. So the more you need to focus on what is important. I think this slide is one of the most important slides you have. then you have section also set 14. This is then we just talked about it. Number 15. Okay. See, this one is good, but shouldn't you also have a general formula, expected value ETX, just to give the
yes, that's actually also to provide the method how we get this one.
Yeah, so you don't need to provide the method, you just need to put the general formula.
General formula of the speech is what?
Yeah, of the what is the general formula, just to make the people remind that what is the NGF formula, what is the CF formula. Expected value, no need, okay? So, but you can still also put this one is X, and then this is FX, DX, something like this.
I think so, this slide, but not this one like this one.
Okay, I think that but you can but those slides you should have.
Okay, this one.
But don't show it unless they ask.
Okay.
Yeah, this is the question. But for that one, you just give the general formula.
Okay.
So then people, some of the graduate students, they maybe forget already.
MGF of the simple or the mixture.
Just the MGF of any distribution.
Okay.
So an MGF of any distribution looks like this. And this is the results for our work. But also, if there a way, if you go back to your information there, the number 15, right? 15, 16, so. See, is there a way that you can show this line by line?
Yes.
Yeah, if you can, it's better. Because you don't need to do animate this, only animate the result. So show this first. This doesn't need to be animated, because that would be the first one. The next one, and the next one, the next one. Because when you animate, then you can, people know what you're talking about. Because I think you have to offset your English a little bit. So I think your English is not clear when you talk, but if it's animated, it's easier people to follow you. So I think at a certain point, especially this part, people not following you. You're saying this is the result, this is the result. But if you do the animation, or people can, at least if they don't hear too much yours, they can concentrate. They can see this one is this. He's talking about characteristic function. This one is this, and so on and so forth.
Because sometimes when I see the presentation of the doctor or professor, he mm-hmm. uses the latex, there is no animation.
Yeah, because this is the latex. The professors, see, they are teaching all the time, so they talk all the time. So for you have a problem, you don't teach at all,
yeah.
And then you don't compare yourself with the professors, okay? Because the professors, we teach, and then here we show this, and we say this is this. Then we go to the board. You can go, actually, this is how it's defined. So then after that, we talk about this one result. You could do that. But there will long presentation. Instead of that, you offset that by animation. Okay. So then this is the result after we've done the work. And then see, also you should say that this is to answer the properties of the distribution. This is research question number one, right?
Mm.
So this is, you can say somewhere here, no, to answer for research question number one.
Okay.
for the slides for this one. So then the other one, when you have a maximum,
we just put in the beginning of this slide.
Yeah. So parameter estimation for answering research question number one.
Okay.
Something like this. So then the people know you're talking about research question number one. So and so on and so forth. You have three research questions. These are the research questions. So the animation is will be helpful for you, I think. Because I wanted to see. That's why I need the presentation here. So then, there from the session number 18. Slide 18. You say the method of moments. So you show the method of moments. Okay, here. Now, maybe they will ask you, what is M1? What is M2?
M4.
I don't know. But how do you get that? You probably need to put the summation xi, so M1. You just need this. Okay. That's what you need. Somewhere in the slide, you might want to write maybe here, or maybe here. Okay. Mk equals the summation of this. From the data, okay. So that would improve this. If they ask you, then there is it. Okay. So also this, if you can animate one by one, would be better. Okay. And then you want to say you want to solve simultaneously. What do you want to solve? Solve simultaneously. The first to the fifth moment of the twistage. It's actually no. See, what you want to see when you see this is equating the first fifth to the fifth moment to the twistage means the logistic distribution and solve simultaneously for the parameter.
Okay.
Yeah. See, because you're putting everything in one sentence, so you should say equate the first to the fifth moment of the twistage mixture distribution. To solve for the solve simultaneously for the parameters lambda, beta, so on, p, so on. Okay, the parameters. Number 21.